This example is to construct a modified box plot for the random sample of 11 ages. So when we're doing any type of percentile, we'll need quartiles for our box plot. You want to order your data from smallest to largest. So the first thing, you can use your calculator to sort this. It's a very small data set, so I'm just going to sort them from smallest to largest. Next thing we're going to do is actually find where the quartiles are. So we are going to actually first look at where we go in the data set to find our 25th percentile, which is the same thing as the first quartile. And we're going to use this constant here, where n is your sample size and p is the percentile that you're trying to find. So when we're trying to find q1, we're going to use for our count over 11 for our sample size. There's 11 items here. And then the percentile would be the 25th percentile. So that's really the same thing as taking 11 times 0.25, if you want to do that a little bit shorter way. That comes out to be 2.75. And the rule in our textbook is that anytime you get a decimal, you always round up to the next integer and count out that many spots. So we would round this up to 3, count out to the third data point, and that value would be our first quartile. So Q1 equals 23. Next, we want to find our 50th percentile, Q2, and that's really going to be the same thing as also the median, but we would look at our placement here, our constant, is 11 times 50 over 100. That comes out to be 5.5. Again, a decimal, so we round up to the sixth data point, count out to the sixth data point in our ordered data, and that gets us our second quartile. So Q2 is equal to 29. And then for the last quartile, which is the same thing as the 75th percentile, we would take 11 times 75 over 100, comes out to be equal to 8.25. It's a decimal, round up. Don't use your regular rounding rules. Round up to the next integer, so that's the ninth value in the data set. Count over 9 numbers, and that ninth value would be your third quartile. So Q3 equals 36. Now, one thing I asked you to do here is a modified box plot. Modified in the fact that we're actually going to check for outliers. So if it just said construct a box plot, it's not going to worry about outliers. Modified box plots actually would include the outliers in the graph as a little asterisk out on the whiskers. To check for outliers, we're first going to find our interquartile range. Somewhat long word, so we're going to shorten that to IQR. And it's simply Q3 minus Q1. So if we go into what we just found on our previous page there, the IQR for this example would be equal to 36 minus 23. So there's 13 units long between Q1 and Q3, or the middle 50% of your data is going to be 13 units long on your number line. Then we're going to use the IQR to find two limits. And I'm going to call the first one the lower limit, which I'm just going to shorten as LL for lower limit. Sometimes it's also called the low. So our lower limit is equal to Q1 minus 1.5 times the IQR. Of course, make sure you multiply before you would subtract. So if I substitute in, our Q1 value was equal to 23, and the IQR was equal to 13. So that comes out to equal 3.5. So any age younger than 3.5 years old would be considered an outlier on the left-hand side or the lower side. the upper limit is going to be Q3 plus 1.5 times the IQR. Q3 is 36. Same IQR as before was 13. So our upper limit comes out to equal 55.5. So anybody that's older than 55.5 years would be considered an outlier. So if I go back to my original data, if you have it in order when you're going through, you can quickly see that I don't have anybody as young as the 3.5-year-old mark, so there's no outliers on the left. But I do have one person in here that's older than 55.5. This value here is going to be considered my outlier. And what's going to happen then is that we're going to have this new value here as the max, excluding our outliers, and our whisker will only go to 49 instead of out to 58. Sometimes you can have multiple outliers. You might have one on either side, or maybe two or three on one side, and only one on the other side. You just mark each one with an asterisk, and after you take out all the outliers, the next largest or next smallest value, excluding outliers, would be your min and max. So with these values, we're going to actually call this one the minimum. It's called the five-number summary. The min, Q1, Q2, Q3, and the max plus outliers. If you don't have a modified box plot, of course you wouldn't have any outliers. The max is always the largest number in your data set. We're going to put all of those six numbers on a number line. So we need a number line that's going all the way from 15 years old out 58 years old. I'm going to start a new page for this. And these can go vertical or horizontal, but the plot itself shouldn't sit on the axes. So your axis is just for your number line. I'm going to go ahead and start at 15 and then just count by fives. Starting with Q1 and Q3, we're going to make a rectangle. So the value for Q1 was at 23, so identifying that on the number line. So here, approximately 23. Up in the air, not on the line itself, is the edge of the rectangle. Q3 is over here at 36, is your other side of the rectangle. That's the box of the box plot. Then we're going to identify Q2, or the median. And then inside this box, you get a vertical line right at Q2. On the left, our smallest number was at 15, so here's our minimum value right at 15. We're going to have what's called a whisker. It goes right in the middle of the box out to the smallest value in the data set and stops. And then the largest number is going to go out to 49, our maximum value. And if you were to pretend like you're extending this line all the way out, that's going to be our outlier. It's right at 58. We get a little asterisk. And we should always, of course, put some type of unit on there, description that this is age. Now we can do this in the calculator as well. So for the same example problem, to get this picture in the TI calculator, hopefully you can see this on the screen, but we're going to go into the stat menu. The very first option in there is under edit, and enter in your data. It does not have to be entered in the same order that you ordered it here. It can go in either way, so I put it in as it was originally given to us in the problem. So I put in all 11 of those numbers. Just make sure you don't have a typo. That's important, of course. Once you're done with that, you're going to go to stat plot, which is up here in blue. So I'm going to hit second, y equals. Yours might say off right now. Doesn't matter, but you just want the very first plot in there. So I'm going to hit enter. You're going to want to take your cursor by using your left and right arrow keys. Highlight the on, do the down arrow, and under type, move over until you get the little box plot with two dots next to it. That's the modified box plot. The one without the dots won't check for outliers. So you want this one that's right there. While it's blinking on there, hit enter so it'll highlight it. I have my data in list 1. If you need to change the list, if you had it in list 2 or 3, etc., above the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 keys are the different list names. So you just do second L2 or second L3, whatever list that you have. Leave the frequency as the 1. The mark of a box usually shows up a little bit better than the pluses. That's going to be where your mark is for your outlier. Once you get it set up, go to zoom. And then it's down a little way, so arrow down until you get to zoom stat. Hit enter. And that will automatically resize your window to fit those ages. And to see these values when you're going through, you can hit the trace key. So trace will actually tell you where you're at on the blinking here. Notice the minimum is 15. If I use my right arrow, Q1 is 23. The median, or same thing as Q2, is 29. Q3 is 36. My max is 49. And my outlier is 58. So it's a nice fast way to get to those values. Checking your work on a test, you'd want to show your work and use this as a backup.